Hello and welcome to another Wondershare Repairit video. Today we're tackling a common issue that many of us have run into. The Microsoft Excel cannot paste the data error. It's frustrating, especially when you're in the middle of something important and Excel just won't cooperate. But don't worry, in this video, I'll walk you through some easy steps to fix this issue so you can get back to working smoothly. However, before we get into the details of that, kindly make sure you hit that subscribe button, leave a comment, and let me know if you've ever faced this error in Excel. Your experiences could help others, and it's always great to build a helpful community. But now, let's jump right into solving the problem. The first thing we need to do is to look at why this error happens. Often it's related to formatting issues between cells, or sometimes Excel just doesn't recognize the copied data properly. But there are a few simple fixes we can try to get past this. One common reason for the cannot paste the data error in Excel is merge cells. If you're trying to paste data into a range that includes merge cells, Excel can struggle, especially if the data you're copying doesn't match the merge cell structure. But don't worry, because this is an easy fix. Here's what you need to do. First of all, select the cells where you're trying to paste the information. Make sure you highlight the exact range of cells that should receive the data. Now go to the Home tab in the Excel ribbon at the top of the screen. In the Alignment group, click on the small arrow in the bottom right-hand corner to open the Format Cells dialog box. Once the dialog box appears, go to the Alignment tab. Now look for the Merge Cells checkbox and make sure that it is unchecked. If it is checked, then uncheck it and click OK. Once completed, try pasting your data again. In most cases, removing merge cells from the destination area should resolve the issue. Whilst this is an easy fix, you can see the obvious limitations. But as I promised in the beginning of this video, I have more methods to show you, and it gets even more interesting. Sometimes the standard copy-paste function causes issues, but using Paste Special allows you to control exactly what's pasted, like values, formulas, or formats, without causing the cannot paste the data error. So I will now show you how to go about and use it. Your first steps is to copy the data you want to paste. So select the data by highlighting it and then pressing Ctrl and C. Or if you're on a MacBook, Command and C. Now it's time to select the destination cells where you want to paste the data. So make sure that you choose the exact range where the data should go. Right click on the destination cells, and a menu should pop up. Look for the Paste Special option and then click on it. A Paste Special dialog box should now appear. Here, you'll see several options for what you can paste. For example, you can choose to paste only the values, formulas, or formats. If you are unsure, values is a good place to start, especially if formatting is causing the issue. Once you have selected the appropriate option, then click OK. It's now time to check if the data pastes correctly. By using Paste Special, you're telling Excel exactly what to paste, which often helps avoid the error. Being honest, there is the possibility that another program or background process is interfering with Excel. In cases like this, restarting your PC in a clean boot state might help. So here's how you can do that. On your keyboard, press the Windows and R key to open the Run dialog box. Now type MSCONFIG into the box and then hit Enter. A system configuration window will open up, and when it does, go to the Services tab. At the bottom of this tab, check the box that says Hide all Microsoft services. This will prevent essential system services from being disabled. Next, click Disable All to turn off all non-Microsoft services. Now it's time to go back to the Startup tab and then click on Open Task Manager. When the Task Manager window opens, disable all the startup programs by selecting each one and then clicking on Disable. Once done, you can now close the Task Manager and return to the System Configuration window. And once done, click OK and then restart your computer. Once your PC restarts in a clean boot state, try running Excel again and then paste your data. By running a clean boot, you're eliminating any potential conflicts from third-party programs or services that could be causing the paste error in Excel. Another fix that I have found handy for issues like this error is to ignore Dynamic Data Exchange, or what is simply called DDE. This can sometimes interfere with Excel's ability to paste data correctly. And although it sounds complicated, don't worry, just sit back and I'll now show you how to use this method. With Excel open, click on File and then select Options. In the dialog box that pops up, go to the Advanced section. Scroll down and uncheck the box next to Ignore Other Applications that Use Dynamic Data Exchange, DDE. Click OK to save the changes and then try copying and pasting your data again. And finally, saving the best method for last, we have my personal favourite, and I'm sure you will love it. If none of the previous methods worked and you suspect that your Excel file is corrupted, then you'll need a reliable repair tool. And let me tell you, Repairit Excel Repair is hands down my favorite solution. It's reliable, easy to use, and makes sure your data is intact after the repair process. But enough of the talk, and now let me show you how to use this fantastic repair tool. First of all, launch Wondershare Repairit, and then select More Types Repair. Click the File Repair option to upload your corrupted Excel files. You can also select multiple files if you need to fix more than one at a time. Then click on the Add button and select the Excel file that you wish to repair. Once your file or files are uploaded, hit the Repair button to begin the process. Repairit works quickly, so don't worry, you won't be waiting long. And once the repair is complete, you can click Preview to check out the repaired Excel files before saving. Finally, once you are happy with your repaired files, just click on Save or Save All to store them. You can either save them in the original folder or pick a new destination. Honestly, Repairit Excel Repair is the best tool on the market for fixing Excel files. It's fast, effective, and it makes sure your data is kept safe. And there you have it, 5 different methods to fix the Microsoft Excel cannot paste the data error. So I hope this video has helped you resolve the issue. If it did, then don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more helpful tips. But until next time, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all very soon in the next video.